Like, wow, this is just something someone is born to do, and she's so passionate about it. Every time she's talking, she's just smiling. You know, people, they don't know where to get their, they don't know where to apply for for scholarship. They don't know where to get the right scholarship and everything. And I'm just looking at her, I'm like, wow, this is what somebody is just so proud to do. And she's doing it with all joy and happiness. What is your own purpose? How can we also identify you? Don't tell me that my purpose is to be the accountant in this company. Or my purpose is to be the father figure in this society. What is your purpose, people? Discover your purpose. Are we together? Know your why. Look at this mountain rocket, this mountain climber. Imagine it, you know, usually when they set out to climb a mountain, they'll have a point where they place a flag at the top of a mountain, okay? And they'll see the first person to get there. Imagine him climbing and reaching at the top just to realize that the flag was on the next mountain. Are we together? Let's be intentional, people. Nothing great gets done if we are not intentional. I bet you, even the discoveries that were made, you'll say, oh, they were lucky to discover them. But they have to be intentional about bringing it to daylight. They have to be intentional about showing it to people. Purpose is that big image, that big picture that's in your mind. And you start dividing it in yearly things. What am I supposed to do? What skills am I supposed to acquire within the next 5 years? I need to get to the place where I'll be talking to people. In the next 5 years, I'll be talking to crowds of 1,000 people. I'll be talking to crowds of 5,000 people. Oh, you want to be a public speaker? Good and fine. Within the next 5 years, you can set out yourself to get those skills for public speaking. What do you need? Every day, it can be as simple as just, you know, owning for a leadership post somewhere in the organization where you work. It will really help you expose you to that challenge of facing the crowd all the time and talking. Get closer every day. You want to get to the level where you have companies all over Africa. Get something doing every day. It could be as simple as just getting a friend, even a Facebook friend that is in that country. You know, there was a time I started thinking about this scholarship I wanted to get in Africa. I think it was around Ghana or Nigeria. So I just told myself, well, I'm still in medical school now, or I'm still in my second year. But what if I just start creating a contact now? If tomorrow I want to get there, what if I just start creating a contact with a medical student that is there to enlighten me on how the process is that way? Are we together? Do something every day. Every day, at least one thing. It could be calling somebody. It could be meeting a new person, attending a seminar like this one. It helps you to get closer to your purpose. Maybe there's this understanding you need to have. You want to be talking on marriage and everything. You can read a book every day, every week, every month. Something that will draw you closer to your purpose. That's what we are talking about. And it shows that you are intentional. It shows the speed of your life, because intentional people are running at high speed. All the time they have something doing. They always have something doing. Somehow it's like you don't have a plan, you have a passion. When you're fully convicted, I'm telling you, at all time, you'll be picturing what you want to do. You'll be picturing that company you want to create. You'll be picturing the things that are driving you all the time. Are we ready to build Africa? Are we ready to build Africa?
Yes.
Let's be intentional. Please, let's be intentional. It all begins with the way you handle the things you set yourself out to do every day. You don't just plan to do something and once there's a least challenge, maybe you have a delay and you say, oh, this thing cannot be done again today. Let's be intentional. Are we together? So, where and how do I start? In order to be intentional, in order to start living intentionally, remember, it is living intentionally. So the first thing is first of all to be able to live. Because if you are not living, you cannot be intentional about your living. So where do we start? Purpose discovery. Know your purpose. What were you created to do? That should be our desire from today. Listen, great achievers are known for their purposes, for what they were created to solve in the society. That is how we know them. Great achievers are known for the problems they solved. If you say teenage pregnancy is what you want to terminate, what are you doing about it?
But people see your actions and they know what you were born to do. They say, oh, this lady all the time talking to youths, talking to young girls about teenage pregnancy. Definitely that should be what she was born to do. People are looking at us Africans and they are telling themselves that they cannot help us if we can't help ourselves. People are telling themselves that nothing will change if these people don't want to set out themselves to do that which is needful for themselves. Everything begins with your purpose. What is your why? What is your why? Everybody has a why. Everybody has a purpose in this life. Everybody. Don't feel like your purpose must be to transform the whole nation and build skyscrapers in every city. No. It must not be something that big. Or it must not be something that far. Your purpose, if something as small as, you know, just helping people to get scholarship. I know this Nigerian girl, Dr. Linda Iheme, she just helps people to get scholarships everywhere across the globe. All her platforms, you go, how to get the scholarship, when to start applying, how to get the best scholarships, and everything. And I'm like, wow, this is just what someone is born to do. And she's so passionate about it. Every time she's talking, she's just smiling. You know, people, they don't know where to get they don't know where to apply for scholarship. They don't know where to get the right scholarship and everything. And I'm just looking at her like, wow, this is what somebody is just so proud to do. And she's doing it with all joy and happiness. What is your own purpose? How can we also identify you? Don't tell me that my purpose is to be the accountant in this company. Or my purpose is to be the father figure in this society. What is your purpose, people? Discover your purpose. Are we together? Know your why. Look at this mountain rocket, this mountain climber. Imagine him, you know, usually when they set out to climb a mountain, they will have a point where they place a flag at the top of a mountain, okay? And they will see the first person to get there. Imagine him climbing and reaching at the top just to realize that a flag was on the next mountain. Are we together? What a waste. He would have put out all his energy to get to the top of the mountain, but he was missing his target. Please, let's not miss our target. Let's start living intentionally. Discover your purpose. Okay? And once you discover your purpose, what's the next thing to do? Every day, start doing one thing that will help you to get closer. The same way when you have your purpose is that big ball, that big image that is in your mind. Your purpose is that big image, that big picture that is in your mind. And you start dividing it in yearly things. What am I supposed to do? What skills am I supposed to acquire within the next 5 years? I need to get to the place where I'll be talking to people. In the next 5 years, I'll be talking to crowds of 1,000 people. I'll be talking to crowds of 5,000 people. Oh, you want to be a public speaker? Good and fine. Within the next 5 years, you can set out yourself to get those skills for public speaking. What do you need? Every day, Facebook friend that is in that country. You know, there was a time I started thinking about this scholarship I wanted to get in Africa. I think it was around Ghana or Nigeria. So I just told myself, well, I'm still in medical school now, I'm still in my second year, but what if I just start creating a contact now? If tomorrow I want to get there, what if I just start creating a contact with a medical student that is there too, to enlighten me on how the process is that way? Are we together? Do something every day, at least one thing. It could be calling somebody. It could be meeting a new person, attending a seminar like this one. It helps you to get closer to your purpose. Maybe there's this understanding you need to have. You want to be talking on marriage and everything. You can read a book every day, every week, every month. Something that will draw you closer to your purpose. That is what we are talking about. And it shows that you're intentional. It shows the speed of your life, because intentional people are running at high speed. All the time, they have something doing. They always have something doing. Somehow, it's like they don't have a vacation. Because by the time they finish, you know, by the time they finish with one part of their life, they're already into the second thing. And by the time you ask them, but don't you have a rest? Can't you rest now? You just ended this. Their life is at high speed. Because they know there's always something you can do every day. There's always something. Let's be intentional, people. Nothing great gets done if you are not intentional. I bet you, even the discoveries that were made, you say, oh, they were lucky to discover them. But they had to be intentional about bringing it to daylight. They had to be intentional about showing it to people, showing it to the world. Okay, we know of penicillin, right? The drug used in medicine, penicillin. Sorry, I mentioned a lot into medicine, but penicillin was discovered by Sir Alexander Fleming in 1928. What happened was that any skills is valuable. Anything you learn, and keep stretching yourself. Don't just say you know a lot, but tell yourself, how can I know more? Okay? How can I know more? Are we together? That is what it takes to be intentional. That is how intentional people think. There is American philosopher, Ralph Emanuel Wilson, said, the only person you are destined to become is the person you decide to be. What is that person you have decided to be? What is that person that you keep telling yourself, I want to become this, I want to become this? That picture you paint to yourself. The only person you're destined to become is the person you decide to be. So, rapidly, how can you do that? Again, you can create an accountability, a system of awakening. You know, these are things that can help you to keep you on the right track, to keep you focused all the time. You can have a system whereby they keep on reminding you of what you have to do, your life goals, your life dreams. Take somebody, a partner to whom you're accountable. Somebody that will tell you all the time, where is that book you told me you were going to write? Somebody that will be telling you all the time, oh, you said we're going to buy a car this year. Where is that car? Where is that our car? Where is that our car? My brother, I hope that was one of your goals this year. Ah, see, so where's the car? Okay. So, next thing, you can set deadlines. I have to do this by the end of the year. I have to read 4 books this month of November. You give yourself deadlines. So focus over it. You don't just tell yourself that, but you give yourself a plan. Oh, daily I'll read for 30 minutes. I'll read for 1 hour every week. For example, that is how you give yourself a system of awakening. You are constantly reminded that I have to do something. I put my purpose. I have to do something. The next thing, you can create a reward pattern. You know that, oh, if I achieve this, I'll give myself a treat. Maybe if by the end of the year, I am able to get this number of sales for my company, I'll take a trip to Caribbean. You don't just tell yourself that, because at the end of the day, you can still take a trip even when you don't achieve it. Tell people, tell your company, your accountant, that if I will not get this number of sales, I'm not going for my trip. Are we together? It's such a way that when you fail, they will tell you there's no money to go for your trip. Don't just hide it for yourself, and you know, at the end of the day, when you fail, nobody will know, so you still go for your trip. Meanwhile, you didn't deserve it. Okay? So the next thing, you can also create sanction measures, things that will penalize you, that will pain you. You know, like my friend Bodas, that he said, he gave us a challenge at one point that if I don't write this finishing book by this month, I'm paying everybody in the organization 50K. 50K, of course, we have to be happy. We have to be happy. Oh, please increase it to 100K to show that if I increase it to 200K. Okay, that's just how I was thinking. But it just shows that you are aware of where you want to go to, of what you want to achieve. Are we together? So, obstacles on your way, losing sight of your why. When you lose sight of your why, it distracts you a lot. It can happen maybe because of an incident, you lost a partner or you lost a family member, just life trauma. But that's an obstacle. Just wave it around. Make sure you go through the process and you keep focused on your life, okay? The next thing is doing good things. Remember, good things are the antonyms or the contrary of the right things. You can be doing the good things that are not the right things for you, okay? No matter how much I express my geography knowledge on a mathematics exam paper, I will never have an A grade. No matter how much I give myself, I know a lot of geography, but they're asking me mathematics questions, I'm writing geography. Excellent geography, perfect geography. You think I can have an A grade? There's no way. So, doing good things distracts us from doing the right thing. The right things are those things that are needful for your purpose. They are needful for your life journey, okay? Procrastination, which is the main thing we are going to look at as we round up. Procrastination, always tell yourself, I will do it when you can do it now. Always tell yourself, I still have tomorrow. But you can do it now. Put into tomorrow something you can do today. That is what I call procrastination. And it's the main killer of dreams in Africa. Is the main killer of dreams and visions. Because of course, people fail because they misuse their time. And how do they misuse their time? By procrastinating all the time. They procrastinate. Something you can do now. You always tell yourself, tomorrow. I still have tomorrow. Your CA is in the next 2 months. Well, I still have next month to read. Okay, the CA is in 2 weeks. Half up to 1 week is enough. CA is in 3 days. It's just 2 chapters. I'll read it. CA is tomorrow. That's when you start being in the head. Let me see. And you realize there are 5 chapters you have to read. Can you pass? How can such a person pass? We are talking about people that are sold out. You start today, you are seeing the big picture, but you give yourself today. You make as if today is the only thing you have to do the to achieve that thing. You are giving yourself fully each day as if that was the only thing you had to prepare for that exam. That is what it takes to be intentional. So, rapidly, you see, procrastination. See somebody that has a long to-do list, so many things to do, but he's sleeping. That is what procrastination does. And how do they do that? No sciences. Social media. Social media. That is what is killing us today. Social media. Somebody took his time to engineer a program that is changing the world, but at the same time, wasting your time. You need to have that discipline. Discipline yourself. Discipline yourself. I know of this great CEO of companies. He said, Leadership Academy across Africa. He has this online organization, Steve Courage. He's a Nigerian guy. He has a big YouTube channel. He says, Success Secret TV. I don't know if anybody knows that YouTube channel, Success Secret TV. And he's classified among the top 10 YouTube channels on YouTube talking about success. Has over 1 million+ subscribers. So he said, once he discovered the place, the way social media was draining his time, he decided to quit, delete his Facebook account, quit all social media platforms. And I'm telling you, that is one powerful way to have enough time for yourself. Because social media is just as simple as, oh, let me just keep this and reply a message. By the time you reply a message that was to be replied in 1 or 2 seconds, you already find yourself, you know, like movie says, 2 hours later. You see, time is already wasted. Let's note that this is a main killer. Give out your best. Give out your best at every moment. Don't always feel like tomorrow you have the chance. What if your maker, what if your creator tells you takes you out of the game of life and you have not done the things you were sent to do? What account are you going to give your creator? What account are you going to give the one that gives you your purpose? What account? At all times, let's be conscious that if I should be called now to give an account of this thing, what am I going to say? What am I going to do? How far, how many percent have I achieved? That is what we are talking about. So, you will never be in the moon. I want you to tell your neighbor that. Tell your neighbor, you will never be in the moon. You will never be in the moon to start. And you will never be ready if that's what you're waiting for. You will never be in the mood, you will never be ready. Don't always tell yourself, I'm waiting for when I'll be in the mood, I'm waiting for when I'll be ready. Listen, if you are just waiting for when you'll be ready, let me tell you, you'll be ready when everybody will be done. Because there's never enough, you don't have, like I was giving an example of the capital, you will never have enough to start. Just start with the little you have. Just start from where you have. Don't feel like it's when you'll be prime minister that you start changing lives and you know you start helping people to go to school, helping young people, scholarship, all that. It can start as simple as just a friend, somebody you know that doesn't have means to get a book. It's not when you'll be a billionaire that you start giving scholarships to people. Even when you are still at your level, you can start helping somebody with school fees for a year. It starts at every level. You'll never be ready, you'll never be in the mood. You say, I have to start maybe this YouTube channel by this year ending. I'm still waiting to be in the mood to produce a video. I'm still waiting. They're asking you, at least you had an accountable partner. How far? I'm still waiting to be in the mood. I'm still waiting for the right time. The right time will never come. Okay? The right time will never come. I just want to repeat this after me. Today is the tomorrow you spoke about yesterday. you may want to write it down. Today is the tomorrow you spoke about yesterday. You kept on telling people, I'm going to do this tomorrow. I'm going to do this tomorrow. I'm going to do this and that and that and that. That tomorrow is when? It's today. What can you show about it? What can you show about it? What are those books you have to read? Because of course, readers are leaders and leaders are readers. The reason why I insist on book reading is because that is what opens our mind in the international world. You may be so close to your platform, to your local level, but not knowing what is being done globally. Books open your mind to international standards, to international recommendations. Book open your mind to high-class things, first-class and top-notch knowledge. And if you're not reading books, I bet you, before you realize, if the others are reading books, of course, they will outrun you by far. Books are important. If you tend to say, I have to read this number of books, I have to cultivate myself, self-education, self-development, how far do you go about it? How far? It's just that mindset of seriousness. Intentional people are serious about it. You can't tell people all the time, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow. If I never see the song yet, I'll do it tomorrow, and tomorrow never reaches. Today is the tomorrow you spoke about yesterday. Keep that in mind. Whenever you want to procrastinate, tell yourself that, no, I said I'll do this thing today. It will help you with procrastination. I said yesterday that I'll do this thing today. And today is not tomorrow. Today is today. Let me do it today. Are we together? So what if you were to be called up now and give an account of your life? What are the things that you think you will have done by now? We are in 2020. We are in November. What are the things you think you will have done by now? What are those things you give yourself out? Maybe by this age that you are, I will have achieved this and this and this by now. What are those things? What are the regrets? What do you think could be the regrets? You can write them down. Write them down. Write them down. Okay, don't procrastinate to say later. Write them down. If you can write even one or two now. Okay? What are the things? Think deep within yourself. What are the things that by now you were supposed to have done already? Are you writing them down? Even if it's one or two. And now, what are the things you think you can start doing from today? From today, to start achieving them, to start correcting those regrets. What are the things you think you can start doing from today? From now even. People presented themselves here. You may have realized that your neighbor is the person you needed for you to, have the partner that will boost your business. Do you think you need to go home before you call the person on phone? Discuss with the person here. Are we together? We have a brief time. You can start now. Start now. Correct the regrets. Correct those things. What are the errors that you made? What are the things? What is the lifestyle that needs to change? Remember, your habits need to change today. Your habits need to change. So to conclude, I will just round up with this comment from Kwame Nkrumah. He said, freedom is not something that one people can bestow on another as a gift. Okay? He says, they claim it as their own and no one can keep it from them. You become free when you discover your purpose. You become free when you discover what you were born to do. And once you identify what you were born to do, nothing can stop you. When you are passionate enough about it, nothing can stop you. Once you know what you were born to do, and you set out yourself, to do it, nothing can stop you. And I would like to leave you with this. Coming to Dominion Summit 2020 is a good act. It's excellent. It's great for your self-development. But if at the end, nothing changes in your habit, it means you were not intentional. If at the end, if today you go back home and nothing in your routine changes, it means you were not intentional. And once you discover the things that you have to do, when do you start taking action? When do you start taking action?
Now.
When do you start taking action?
Now.
When do you start taking action?
Now.
When?
Now.
Now. Right? Thank you very much. Training entrepreneurs and people that have the vision of creating companies and going global and starting something local that will go global. So he's out to help them, you know, showing them to the on his platforms and advertising people, training CEOs and leaders. So he said, I sold my bed. That simply means he's giving up his comfort. He's giving up the thing that should console him, the thing that should keep him, you know, warm and in his comfort zone all the time. And it's out for him to make a change. That is what we need. People that are out to make a change. That is what Africa needs. Are you intentional? Are you intentional? I'm not saying you go and sell your own bed today. No, he did not sell his bed physically or so. Just to say, he actually refused to remain in his comfort zone. And that is what it takes. That is what it takes to be outstanding. That is what it takes to be intentional. Okay, next thing, once you discover your purpose, you are convicted about it. Conviction is that strong belief, that strong passion that you have, that strong understanding that this is valuable. I am important. I need to fit myself in the puzzle. Africa is a big puzzle, and everybody has a part to play in it. Everybody has a part to play in the puzzle of Africa. What is your own part? What is the part that you have to play? Are you convicted about it? Do you really believe that people need what you have to offer? Are you intentional about showing yourself to the world, about giving yourself to the world, about dying empty? So passion, the next thing, vision, sorry, is when you have a mental picture of your purpose, when you have an image of where you want to go to, where you want this business to go to, where you want this this organization that you're starting, where should we reach? How many people should we impact? Make it clear, write it down. Okay? The next thing, you have an intense desire to bring your vision to reality. That is the place of passion. You desire to bring it to life. You desire to make your intentions to come to reality. That's because you have a picture of it. You have a vision and you are convicted. You are passionate because you have a picture in your mind that is driving you all the time. Are we passionate? Are we passionate? Well, so why is it important to be intentional? Coming back to it, it keeps you focused. Of course, we are in a world where, you know, there are so many things around, so many distractions, so many, you know, somebody will start a business today and by the time they realize the next thing is to go to Dubai, they'll stop the business and they start throwing the process of going to Dubai. By the time they hear, oh, the next thing is to write this compo, they'll come back after writing it. They are not focused. That is not being focused. And if you're intentional enough about your purpose, you realize that other things may be good, but they are not the right things for you. Are we together? You are focused on that course you want to do. The next thing, it helps you to maximize time. Intentional people are time conscious. They make you...
Excuse I always get. Your neighbor was blocking you, right? Well, we are so sorry about that, okay? Okay, so...